In a 2D transformation, earlier we have seen that we have represented the each transformation like translation, rotation and scaling in with the help of 2x2 matrix. But whenever we apply these transformation in a sequence, like we are applying first a translation and then again rotating that object. Sometime we are rotating an object and then translate the object. This means we are applying more than one transformation equation to the same object. When we are applying such operation, at that time we have to convert the 2x2 matrix which we were using earlier to the 3x3 matrix representation. This is because translation is having a addition matrix operation, whereas the other two are having a multiplication. When we apply them in a sequence, then it will be more complex to solve. So first we convert them into a 3x3 form and then solve them. So here I am representing a 3x3 representation of the operation which we have earlier seen. So the first operation which we have earlier discussed was a translation. Translation means we are changing the position of the object and we are representing them, but here I am representing them with the help of 3x3 matrix. So the equation will be x, y and 1. Here 1 is only for converting them into a 3x3 matrix. X dash y dash 1 is x, y, 1 and 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, tx, ty and 1. This is the 3x3 representation of that. If we solve this, we will get x plus tx, y plus ty and 1. Here x dash y dash 1. So the same equation, it is in the same form, but it is in a form of 3x3. Same for the rotation. Same for the rotation, we will represent the rotation equation x dash y dash 1 by x y 1 and rotational factor cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta and cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. By solving them, we will get a plane equation form. Here I have represented only them in the rotation and then scaling. In scaling also, x dash y dash 1 is x y 1 and sx 0 0 0 sy 0 and 0 0 1. If you will solve this, you will get x dot sx, y dot sy and 1. I haven't solved this. You can directly apply the matrix multiplication and solve this. I have directly represented them. So this is the homogeneous coordinate system. We will see some numerical in which we are applying more than one operations and how we are using this matrix form in a 3x3 form. So here this is a question. Find the transformation of a triangle A 1,0, B 0,1 and C 1,1 by a first part is that rotating 45 degree about the origin and then translating 1 unit in x direction and 1 unit in y direction. So here we are considering the rotation is in counterclockwise. I'm solving here for A part. So what they are saying that first rotate it about the origin and then translate the 1 unit in x and y direction. So we have to get the matrix form for both these transformation. First I am completing the rotation part. So R, value of R, as we know that we are having here more than one transformation, so we cannot do it with the help of 2x2 matrix. We have to use the homogeneous coordinate system. I am writing here the value of R in a 3x3 form, that was cos theta, sin theta, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0 and 0, 0, 1. So value of theta is 45 degree, we are directly applying it, cos 45, sin 45, 0, minus sin 45, cos 45, and this. putting the value of 45 cos 45, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So this is the part of the rotation. Then we have to translate one unit in x and one unit in y direction. This means we are having tx and ty as 1. So we will calculate that translation part also. We know the value is 1 0 0 0 1 0, and tx value is 1, ty value is 1, and this is 1. So we get the two transformation matrix form. We have to make them a composite. Here we are combining them, so we have to find out r dot t. As we know that in matrix multiplication we have to see that r dot t is not equals to t dot r. So this is the main part we are applying here, rotation, and after that we are translating them. So we have to write this rotation dot translation form, r dot t. So value of r is 1 by root 2, 0, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. And t is 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1. So this is the r dot t rotation and transformation matrix multiplication. We will get this value. Now we will find out directly the coordinate of the new transformed triangle. So the value is that p dash equals to p dot. In the case of translation we are directly writing it here t, and in the case of rotation we are directly writing them r. But here we are writing the combination of these two. So first write down the value of this. And the value of p. So the value of p will be the coordinates of the triangle which is given to us, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 1. As we have to write them in the form of 3 cross 3, so we will write it here directly as this. Now solve it by matrix multiplication, we will get 1 by root 2, first row by first column, 1 by root 2 plus 1. Next, again 1 by root 2 plus 1, last will be 1. Now second row by first column, second column and third column, we will get 0 multiply by this plus 1 multiply by this plus 1 this. So we will get 1 minus 1 by root 2. Now second part, 1 by root 2 plus 1, third 1. Last row, first column, second column and third column, we will get 1 by root 2 multiply by 1 plus 1 multiply by 1 by root 2 plus 1 multiply by 1. We will get 1. Next, 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 plus 1, and this part will be 1. So these two are the coordinate of a dash, these two are the coordinate of the b dash, and these two are the coordinate of c dash. We can solve them or we can directly write down them. So value of a dash will be 1 plus root 2 by root 2, like this, and similarly b dash and c dash.